visible?
Yeah, it is visible.
Okay. I think for a number to be prime, it should be divisible either by one or by itself.
Yeah, I think zero. Don't take zero now. Forget about zero because zero is not a prime.
I think we have to ignore zero. So if there is any range that we want to calculate the prime number from, if it starts from zero, we should ignore zero.
Okay.
I think if you in Python there is a range function
Yeah.
where you can basically say from what to what. So if I say 0 to 100, it will start from 0 but and it will go till 99.
Absolutely right. So what will you do to get to 100?
I will iterate over this range. Range. Now I have to ignore zero, so I'll start from
Yes, start from one.
1 to 100. I mean, if you want to check for a prime number between 1 to 100, then I think the last number should be 101 so that it can calculate till 100.
Yeah.
Now here the problem is if I here is the problem.
So try to break. See, that's where I'll tell you. Try to break the problem into smaller parts. Find the prime separately. Take one problem at a time.
Okay.
Range of prime numbers we'll solve afterwards. Let's solve prime first.
I think any number is divisible by one.
Yes.
So here also to find the prime, I'll have to I mean I'll have to check a range of 1 to 1 till that number a little bit.
Okay.
So I first tried to understand the logic of prime. So I mean if we have a prime number then it is only divisible by one and itself. So if it is divisible by any other number then it should return false. I mean I've tried to put together some piece but now I need to
Yeah.
fix it
Okay, yeah.
little bit.
Right. So we are going to do two things. In fact, right now, what we will do is whatever you're trying to do, we would like to do it using a function because, and without a function, first we will write a function which is going to return me a prime number or not. Okay. And with one without a function. With function, it is simple. Without function, we'll see that there is a bit of a trick there that you will learn. So first, declare a function to find a prime number. Yes.
Should I declare a function?
Yeah. To just to find a prime number.
Now, if I want to find a prime number, I need to provide something here. So, and I want to find a prime number within a range, right?
Okay, so we are solving always in computer programming or anywhere, it's always try to break the problem into smaller steps. and then call them individually. So it's only about prime number. Given a number, whether it is a prime or yes or no. That's all. Not a range as of now.
Okay. So I have created a function where I will pass a number and this to check if this number is prime or not.
Yes.
Now what I want to do is, so I don't need range or anything. I don't need a list. I'll directly check if this is less than equal to 1, then it will return false. Or I try, rather than I do that, right? Then what I'll do is from 2 to n, I will run a loop where I will check if n is divisible by any of those numbers. If it is equal to 0, then it will again print the same thing. Hello.
Yeah, so we will try to run this program and see what.
So I'll okay, now okay, right. What happened?
Okay. Okay, again do it.
Yes. Invalid syntax.
Okay, two to n, right? So it is two comma.
Now, what should I do to run this? I have to call the function, right?
Yeah, you need to call the function.
Saying not prime.
Okay, great. Just give some prime number, 7.
It is saying prime number, but it is printing it multiple times because I have put it inside the for loop.
So you got to look into these parts as well, because the programming becomes, you cannot have something like this, right? So first of all, our purpose is to say yes or no. So not interested in print, in fact, yes or no is what we are interested in. So input is a prime number, output is a true and false.
Okay.
Why do we need this? Why? Because at the end, that is what is required, because printing is for you to know it, which is good for debugging, no doubt about it. But somebody has to use your program. It is only possible by returning a value.
Okay. All right. So I should return a Boolean value, right?
Yes, Boolean value. So, well, it is not going to work, right? It is going to return, okay, now it is fine. But then will it really work? We need to see that and return true, you are telling, right? Let's try to see that and let's try to print it.
Okay.
And give different types of examples. So this is a testing phase.
Will this work?
Yeah, this will work. So it is working. How about 19? Give 19. Perfect. And what about 20? See, about 20. So that's really good. And why break? Break is not required because it will never now. Because earlier it was required. Now break is redundant, right? Because you return.
Okay.
You don't require break now because you return from the statement directly from there. So break would never be coming there. So if we are going to give 27, just check with 27. It is not going to work. 27. Put 27 there. Even 9, if you put, it is not going to work.
It gave true.
Yeah. So 27 is divisible by 3 and all, right? You got my point. What went wrong? Even 9 will not work.
Yes. Right.
So what happened is you what you have tried to see that if even the first condition earlier where all the even numbers when you gave it worked by because they got divided by 2 and hence return false. But then any odd number you giving now it is not working, which is divisible by any other numbers, right? Which is not a prime number. So what do you do for that? So that what is the step? The step says so you need to tell yourself to what is the step for telling a prime number. Step is this thing that I am going to divide by all the number from the 2 to the whichever number minus 1. And if it is able to divide, then it is not a prime. But if it is not able to divide till n minus 1, then only I consider it as a prime. So you this has to be done where? So till. That till says that after the for loop. It is always after the for loop, right? You got my point?
Right. Yeah. So this should not be there. Now the problem is if I am returning false here, that is, it is not a prime. If I return true after the for loop, then even if this thing gives false, at the end I am returning true.
Exactly. So how exactly function works like this? If it returns, it returns. It never comes back. The next statement never gets executed. If it returns, it returns. It comes out of it.
Okay. So now if I return false.
Yeah. So you know, these are the common mistakes a lot of people do. You got to look at it like till when. So if you are trying to tell that, you know, till my number ends, if nothing divides it, then it is called prime. So it has to be after the for loop. So these are things which you have to keep in mind, and this comes with practice. And these are the logical errors which people make. But then if you solve many problems like that, you will be able to get a hang of it.
Okay.
But then before that, you need to write it on a paper, right? And see, for me, it's like visually I can imagine it. But for you in the starting, you might have to write it on a piece of paper or somewhere that this is what I'm expecting it.
Yes, right.
So you solved one problem of prime number. And right now we need to solve another problem, which is finding the range now. Range of prime numbers. Now it becomes a simple problem once you have written a small function. So let's solve the range of prime numbers from whatever. The range could be from whatever number, from n1 to n2. Right?
Okay.
Take an input from the user n1 and n2. And then.
All right. Can I take input like this or
You can assign it yourself. N1 comma n2 equal to, you can give it equal to whatever. I mean, not like this, not input, you give it manually yourself right away. Like you can give 2 comma 40, you can tell 2 comma 40. This is also you can assign in Python. This is called a tuple assignment.
Right.
So 2 comma 40 is a tuple.
Yes.
So now you have this. Now you need to find out a range between 2 to 40.
I think this should work.
Yeah, this should work. This should work. So now you saw the thing, the earlier what you were trying to do, it was very difficult. Just to have a function, you broke a problem into smaller problems and you solved one smaller problem and then you solved the outer problem after using the smaller problem. So that is how you make it simple. But now if you don't have the function, how would you do it? That is a difficult problem. And you should do that once. And then without using a function, how would you do now? But at least you have a hint of how to find out whether it's a prime or not. Now try to solve that.
Yes. Now, if I want to do it without the function, then, I mean, I can copy paste, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Can I use break here? Because break will break out of the loop, or I want to continue.
Okay.
I have some spaces in the invitation. Outside function. Prime list. But this is giving an error. Return outside function.
So return statements are only for functions.
Yeah, right. And then this proportion is this portion is a bit difficult where I mean, what should I do here? I mean, if any of this becomes true, then my number is not prime, and yeah. I should not be able to append it to the prime list.
Yeah. Let's talk about in English. What does that mean? This quote says that if any of it is divisible, that means this is not a prime. So what does that mean? I don't have to really, first of all, the first thing is that what should you do? Let's just stop. We don't have to really check anything. No for loop. I don't need a for loop. So for that, what will you do? I don't need a for loop anyways, no. So what do you do for that? Continue will again continue with the for loop. As soon as I come to know, I don't have to really divide any further because I know that it is not a prime. Yeah, so you're going to use break, absolutely. So that's great. So now break is there, it's okay. Well, you came out, but then still, how do you know whether it is a prime or not? How will you append it to? So what is that factor? That's the thing which you're going to learn now.
This problem was solved. But this should also be break, right?
No. I think for n in range n1 to this thing, no, that is very good. That's really good. So you know that is that will not be break. So that's fine because you're trying to say that it is anyway not a prime, but then I have to check other number. Break would be like, okay, I don't have to continue, but you have to check other numbers, right? So so continue and break is something like this. I still have to be within the for loop, continue. I don't need to do anything now. I have, the purpose of for loop which I wanted is not required, break. Here I told that if I gave n1 as 1, right? So 1 would come there. So I don't have to really check 1. So leave it. So that's fine. That's really good. In fact, that's
okay. Okay. So this section is fine.
Yeah.
And if any of this comes true, we will break out of the loop and it is not required. But if we break out of the loop, we will not append n here because it is clearly not a prime number.
Yes.
So,
So what would you do? You are absolutely right. So in English terms, now start looking at, start talking as an English now. So start visualizing as in the English language, right? So don't see coding because people get mistaken in coding in that they start looking at the code point of view. The whole focus goes to code. Start talking in terms of English. If this happens, that means I am not going to append it, as you said, right? And what is that indicator? I need some indicator for doing it. I need to have some. What will that indicator will be telling that whether I should put it or not? So you need to. As that is your mind, so now consider you and laptop, there is no much difference. What do you do? Exactly has to be coded there. You yourself told that if it is divided, I'm going to break and I'm not going to put it as prime. And why you will not put it as prime? Because it was divided by some number. And yes. That you know it, but computer doesn't know it. So you need to tell computer that, yeah, this was not a prime. So you need some sort of, because you have a memory, you know it. So in programming world, memories are nothing but variables. So you need to use some variables to store that value, telling that it is not a prime.
Okay.
How do you do that? Just think about it, I'll tell you anyway. So you need a variable. So you understood, variable is a memory. In computer, variable stores, variable is a memory. So can you, different types of variables could be there, Boolean, integer, whatever you can use. It's up to you. You decide on, so it's an indicator for you. It's not a prime. So how can you store it? How would you store it if it is, it is a prime or not prime? What type of variable would you have it?
I should have a true or false.
Yeah, so what type of variable would you have it?
Let this be
okay.
For now.
Okay,
great. Now, if I in range, if I'm breaking out of this loop, then is prime remains false. So now here, within this for loop, I will check if is prime. No, but I also have to set the value of is prime to true somewhere.
Can you think in a different way? Because when you say that it is not a prime, that is the time you make it, you know, it's a not a prime. So you should think it is a prime. Then only you can do it, right? So it's opposite way. Initialization of is prime should be to true.
Okay, so if I have initialized it with true, now if I'm breaking it, I should if is prime, then prime is dot append n and print. I think this
should, okay. Can you go in and run it mentally, like from and given n1 as 2 and 40, and then you can see take it some value a bit like 3 or 4 comes in. And just do it for any value like 4 or something and see what happens. Or let's say put two contiguous values, you have to check. Will it work or not? You need to see that.
Okay.
If you can do it, it's fine. But otherwise, you will run it, you will get to know what's going wrong. You run it once. It will be too much for you right now, as of now.
No, so to do it mentally, I mean, I can speak out loud for now, I mean, without running it.
Yeah, right.
So if I have, if I say I've taken a number from 2 to 5, so if I start with 2,
yeah,
then this will continue. Now for 3, it will continue. Here, it will try to, modulo it with 2, it will not get 0. So is prime will not be, it will not come inside this loop. So here it will check if is prime is true. I mean, the value is still true. So it will append 3 here. Now for 4, it will check if it is divisible by 2. If it says that it is 0, then it will change this to false. It will break out of this loop. Here, it will not get true, so it will not append it.
Okay.
Similarly, right. Finally, the whole range will be completed. And if I try to...
You check for 6? Can you check for 6 or 5? Let's say for 5, what will happen? Because for 4, what happened? Is prime is false, right?
Right.
Let's say for 5, what happens?
Okay, for 5... it will continue. Here it will first modulo it with 2. It will not get 0. So yeah, it will not get 0. So we'll go back here and we'll try to divide it with 3. It will again not get 0. Then it will try to divide it with 4. It will not get 0. Then it will try to divide it with, but it will not divide it with 5. But it is not required also.
It will not divide. It's not required. Yeah.
So now the whole range is complete. It will come out and here the value of is prime is still true. No, so it will append it.
It is not true. It is false.
Why?
It is false. Because you never went. You were inside the for loop, right? Is prime is initialized as true on the top.
Hmm.
Because once you made 4 was, if 4 is a is prime, for the 4 it was false. So it remains.
Okay. Right.
That's how you start thinking now. So now you got the pattern of thinking. Yes. How to think. Yeah.
Right. So okay, got it. Because for 4 is prime was set to false.
Yeah.
So if I'm setting it to false here and I'm breaking it, I need to do something so that for the next range it again sets is prime to true.
Yeah.
So for that, I think instead of putting it here, I should have it here.
Right. Very good. Perfect.
For every run, it will first set the value of is prime to true and then check. And finally, at the end, if it is still true, it will append it. Otherwise, it will not append it and it will go back to the next value in the range, in the for loop.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So should I run this now?
Yeah, you can run this. Okay, so I think that's the way you do it. So mentally, if you do it yourself, what happens is, like, I know it requires some practice, then in that case, what happens is you don't have to really do, the mistakes will not happen, and you will not get panicked also. And then that you choke, right? If a mistake happens, people usually choke.
Right.
So that will not happen mentally if you can start. And that's how a good programmer does. Stalwarts would be so good that, you know, 100 lines of code they will see and they can mentally run it in their mind.
Okay. But so that will take some time, right?
Yeah, that will take some time.